In this illustration, we'll be analyzing the interference of light reflected by two inclined mirrors. We are given that two plane mirrors and a monochromatic source of light are arranged as shown in the figure. This figure is a setup which we call as the Lloyd mirror setup for interference of light. Here the angle theta is very small and we are required to find the fringe width of interference pattern obtained on a screen for the system as shown. And the light wavelength is also given to us as lambda. So here, first we'll analyze the given setup as a limiting case of Young's double slit experiment. To analyze it, I'll redraw the figure. We are given with the two inclined plane mirrors shown here. And from vertical, both of these mirrors are inclined at an angle theta and theta. And at a distance A, we have placed a source. So, in both of these mirrors, at the same separation where source is located, two images are obtained, S1 and S2. And if we talk about a screen, which is located at a distance B from the source, light beams will be coming from these two images, S1 and S2. So, for this screen, these are the two sources from where monochromatic coherent light beams are incident, and the separation between S1 and S2 can be taken as capital D from where the light is coming. So in this situation we can consider this as a limiting case of Young's double slit experiment, in which we can say small d is the slit separation, capital D is the separation between a slit plane and the screen. Now in this situation, if we analyze the interference pattern on a screen, first we need to calculate a small d and capital D. So here, if we talk about this separation S1 and S2, then we can write, if this angle is theta, these two angles will also be theta by symmetry. So here we can write in figure shown, distances SS1 is equals to SS2, and this distance will be equal to, if this is A, this distance is A cos theta, so this will be 2A cos theta. Now, in this situation, if we wish to calculate the value of D, then we can calculate the separation between S1 and S2 is, the separation we can write as D, which is twice of 2a cos theta multiplied by sin theta. As this is 2a cos theta, so half of distance is 2a cos theta sin theta, which we are getting is 2a sin 2 theta. And in this situation, the value for a small angle theta, we can write approximately as 4a theta. We can write as theta is small. We already given in the problem that theta is small. Now, if we wish to calculate the value of capital D, which is the separation between the slit plane and the screen, then here we can calculate the separation between slit plane, which is line S1, S2, and screen. This can be given as capital D, and the value would be this B plus, this can be written as 2a cos theta cos theta, so this can be written as 2a cos theta multiplied by cos theta plus B. And for a small theta, we can neglect cos theta as this will be 1. So here we can write, for a small theta, we can write cos theta to be approximately equals to 1. The value of capital D we can approximate as 2a plus b. So now in this situation, if we calculate the fringe width in interference pattern from YDSE, we already studied that fringe width beta is given as lambda d by small d. So here it is lambda multiplied by 2a plus b. divided by small dv right as 4a theta. That is the result of this problem.